YouTube land, Rival here. Thanks for stopping by. We got just a good old-fashioned pimp drop video on the turntable for you guys this week, and I am happy to say these are two Spyderco's knives I have not worked on in quite some time. So it was fun to work on something a little bit different from what I've been doing a lot of lately, which is anodizing titanium, stuff like that. We'll start with this guy. Gentleman had gotten specifically some desert ironwood. This is a Gale Bradley 2. It's a M4 steel knife. Pretty nice overall, extremely ergonomic. It comes in a carbon fiber scale that is shadow boxed, so you see a little bit of the steel liner underneath poking through all the way around the knife. So he wanted to extend the scale over the entirety of the frame, get a little cutout to make opening the knife easier because it has this awkward bump, which ergonomically makes sense, but opening-wise poses a little bit of a challenge. So that notch right there kind of lines up, you know, to make it opening a bit easier. And he wanted to go for a little bit more classic look, old-timey knife look, is what I always think when I think wood. But this wood in particular turned out extremely nice. Desert ironwood is known for these blonde knots and these high contrasting colors. I don't know how much the camera is capturing, but I mean, in addition to the knotting, like the burl, you got these swirling grains, you've got some dark colors with light spots, and those light spots are kind of iridescent in the sunlight. So it really adds depth to the scale that you don't normally get with carbon fiber or just a plain composite. You know, you can actually see some literal life in these scales. They do have a nice rounded contour. The original scales were just flat with some light chamfering on them. Being wood, it is a bit thicker than the standard scales would have been, but really not that much so that you'd really notice. And I think the beauty that those scales add makes up for the fact that they're just a hair thicker in the pocket. You know, again, when I thinned out these scales, it really, really started to show some of the knurling the knotting in the wood. Just some amazing grains showing up in there. So that one turned out extremely nice. All we did to that one was just those scales. And then this one, I haven't worked on one of these in quite some time. This is a Chokwe. Never knew the official way to say this thing. But this has always been a quirky favorite of mine. Spyderco really kind of doing something different on these things. They have been long out of production, so I haven't seen one of these in quite some time. This one's a little beat up. So what we did was a dark blue anodizing on the titanium, gave it a rough tumble, and then gave it purple underneath that. So in the light, you get a little blurple action. It looks pretty nice. Not, you know, bright purple like, oh my god, it's purple on a knife, but just enough to give it a little bit of a pop. I got a little carbon fiber over travel stop to match the carbon fiber scale that we put on the front. Just your standard 2x2 twill. And then gave the blade a nice acid stone wash. It's normally just this full flat ground satin S30V blade. It's like three and a quarter inches. I mean, technically 3.5 when you go shoulder to tip, but you've got a little bit of a choil there, so you can choke up on it. Again, you know, it looks funky, but ergonomically, it's really not that bad. The angles kind of serve good purpose. Gives you good grip here for forward cutting, and it's super super thin and super slicey. So these knives, again, always been a personal favorite of mine. It's one of three Spydercos I actually still own. I got one of these. I got Nirvana, and then a little man bug, little keychain knife. So yeah. Oh well. The only other thing I did to this knife, and I don't know if you're going to be able to even see it. Probably not. I jeweled the entirety of the inside liners. So the inside liner here, as well as the inside of the titanium, is jeweled. And even just for shits and giggles, when you take the top scale off, it's jeweled underneath the top scale. So nobody will ever see that, but I know it's there. And I think it's cool. Let's see if we can get you some of this. Yeah, I don't think you're going to see the jewel in there, guys. Sorry. Well, anyways, it's there. So yeah, color on this one turned out nice. Stone wash on this one turned out nice. One more chance. You can kind of see some swirls in there, but whatever. So yeah, jeweled on the inside, jeweled underneath the scale. I think the carbon fiber scale on these things looks pretty nice. So yeah, that's what we've got. Pair of Spider Co's in the custom shop this week. I actually will be doing a review on this guy real quick. This is a EDC headlamp that I've been carrying for a couple of months now, and I have grown quite fond of this little bugger. So I'll share some thoughts on that in a future video, but until that day, like and subscribe. Thanks for stopping by. Peace.